Hello guys, this is Talented Developer. In this video, we are going to learn about JSON, which is the most important concept you can learn as a programmer and as a web developer. So, what is JSON, why we should know about JSON, and what is the syntax? I will also show an example of JSON, so make sure you stick around till end. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. It is simply data representation format, very similar to XML. It is easy to read and write because it is nicely integrated with JavaScript, and JSON is superset of JavaScript. Nowadays, every web services and API is using JSON because it is very lightweight and a small size. Every language has library or built-in function to parse JSON string into object or classes. JSON can have file extension with .json. Let's move to the other section, that is JSON type. It can have null. It can have a string, like here you can see John. It can have also number including like integer, float. It will be boolean also, like true or false. It can also contain array of number or a string. It can be object, like object means here key and value pair. So how we can write JSON and how we can understand the JSON. So let's move that section. So always JSON is standing for the curly braces. Like means like it will start with the curly brace. Okay. After that, it can have key and value pair. Okay. Always key means like it is a field name, and value means it will contain the field, and it is the differentiate between key and value. We are using the colon. If we are having more data, then we will use comma. Okay, so this is the simple format of the JSON. It will always start with the open and curly braces. So I am going to show one example. Okay, then we will move to the real example. Here I am using the file name as movies.json. JSON will always start with here opening and closing braces. So I am giving here key and value pair. Here key is a title, that means like field name, and the value will contain the field value, the Avengers. Here I am using comma. Comma means I am having the next value. If I don't have any next value, don't try to use the comma, otherwise you will get the error. Then I am going to use the number. Number will never comes with the double quotes, otherwise it will consider as a string. Similarly, I am going to use the boolean value. It can be true or false. It will also not comes under double quotes, but the field name will always start with the double quotes. Here I am also using the array of the string. Here you can see the value is action, adventure and superhero. That means like index of 0 will contain action. Here we can use nested value also, like here you can see cast is a array. Okay, that will contain the nested array. So here you can see I am having two array. First array of name will contain Iron Man, next one will contain the name as a Captain America. So in zero of index of cast, you can see I am having one field name as a powers, that is also an array. So here you can see power is an array. It will comes under cast. Okay, so you can see how we are defining every field name is starting with double quotes. Okay, then we are using colon. Don't try to forget to enter the colon, otherwise you will get surely error. Always follow the structure, that means like opening and closing braces, double quotes, colon, and if you are having more data, try to use comma. Please remember that when receiving data from web server, the data is always a string. So we need to use JSON.parse and the data becomes the JavaScript object. Okay. So similarly, when we are sending data to the web server, the data has to be string. So we have to use JSON.string file. It will convert JavaScript object into a string. Here I am going to show you an real-time example. Currently I am using WebStorm. You can use any IDE, even you can use Notepad also, no matter. Here I given file name as a movies.json. So here I will start with one array. So here you can see I'm using open and close bracket. That means like we are going to use an array. So what is the next thing? So we have to use opening and closing braces. That means like it is a JSON. So what is first thing? We have to use key and value pair. Here I'm going to give field name as a title. Okay, then we have to use column, then we have to use double quotes if it is a string, and you have to give the name. So I'm going to give the name as a the Avengers. Okay, so if I don't have any data, it's fine. But if I'm using comma, and definitely we need to, either we have to remove the comma or we have to enter the next data. Otherwise, you can see I'm getting here error. JSON standard does not allow trailing comma. So if I'm using comma, that means like I'm having the next data. So next we can give anything here. Released. Then it is a number. So I will just go and give here number as 2012. Okay, so it is a number, so I'm not going to give here double quotes. If I use double quotes, that means it will thought like a string. Next we need to give here one boolean value. So I am going to give here watchable. So either you can use true or false. Okay, here you can see if I use anything other than apart comma, here we will see error. So that means like we have to remove here. So what next? See, again he's thinking like we are going to enter data. Definitely we have to enter the data. Next I am going to give here field name as a cast. Okay, so here if I'm going, that means like it is an array, so he will expect some data. So again inside that one I am going to use an object. So here I'll give field name as a actor. Okay, actor name I'm going to use just like Robert. So here you can see it, this is one object. Okay, similarly I'm going to copy this one, and if I'm having other data, definitely what I said, we have to use comma. Then I'm going to paste here. Here I'm going to change the movie name as a Thor, release date as a 2011. Here you can give like false. Okay, here you can give the actor name as a Chris. Okay, so this is our one JSON data. That things we have to see into the output. So what we can do here, I'm just going to copy this one. Here this is my index.html. here I will come, I will define variable data as a here, and I will go to the round and I will use console. Then I will type console.log and I will just use data. So next what we have to do, just come open into any web browser, go to the inspect. Okay, then you have to go to the console. Here just refresh. Once you will refresh in console, you can see your data. Currently I'm not seeing any data because I have not saved my data. So here you can see it is taking as a array. Definitely it is starting with this one. Then you can see it is having two array. First array is here, second array from here. So here title is showing here the Avengers, right? Next one you can see next title is Thor, right? So again here you can see one more array is there, that is cast, right? Cast will also contain an actor here. See, it will containing as actor. So this is your JSON or my data. So what we can do next one, here I will just come. Okay, I will just use JSON dot stringify, then I will use data. So what will happen, just come refresh here. See here, now it will thought like a normal string, right? So next what I told you, we can use JSON dot parse. So I will just come again, I will define here where data one equal to I'll dot like a string, then I will copy this one and just I'm going to paste here. So this is my string. So what we can do, just use console dot log, then I will use data one, right? Just save. I will come refresh the screen. Here you can see the data, it is showing, but it is also considered like a string. So how we can see, just we have to use json dot parse, and this is one data one. Just save, refresh the screen, and here you can see. So you can understand what is here json dot string 5 will do, what is will json parse will do. So this is a way we can send the data and we can parse or we can stringify. Thank you guys, please subscribe my channel, please like the video and please share with your friends so they can also understand what is JSON.